We've worn jewelry for about as long as humans have been human. For example, these seashell beads found in South Africa date back to about 75,000 years ago. And throughout the millennia, we've gone from bones and shells to coral and jet to carnelian and jade, and then on to gemstones like diamonds and rubies. Jewelry design has come a long way since the Stone Age, and some of the most creative and intricate modern day necklaces can be found, where else? Around the necks of America's favorite rappers. Here's a brief look at some of the greatest chains in hip hop. Back in the 1980s, Run-DMC were among the first hip-hop artists to incorporate flashy, expensive necklaces into their overall style.
They took my chain!
They did what? What'd they do?
Alright,
stay right there, we coming right now.
Rope necklaces, particularly those made of gold, have long been popular in men's jewelry. But very thick gold rope chains became an integral part of hip-hop style in the 80s and 90s. Rappers like Big Daddy Kane, LL Cool J, and Eric B. and Rakim are among the most famous chain sporters of the era. The transition from gold to much more expensive diamond and gemstone encrusted chains was a gradual one. Of course, diamond chains were around in the 1990s. For example, top stars at Death Row Records, Tupac Shakur level people, were rewarded with diamond chains of the shocking Death Row logo, while lower level employees had to settle for mere gold. But there's one person in particular who helped diamonds take over in hip hop, and he's not a rapper, he's a jeweler. Jacob the Jeweler, born Jacob Arabo, became one of the most famous people in the late 90s and early 2000s hip hop. Name dropped in nearly 70 songs, Jacob was the go-to jeweler for hip-hop's jet set. People like Diddy, Jay-Z, Busta Rhymes, and Pharrell were just a few of his high-profile clients.
I would design Jay-Z a new watch. Last watch I designed for him called Black Caviar, and he loved it. It's all over magazines, he's wearing the watch.
In fact, he recently collaborated with Kanye West to create jewelry for the Yeezy fashion line. These days, there's more than one go-to jeweler. Elliot Avion is pretty in demand in the hip-hop world, collaborating frequently with Quavo, Offset, and Takeoff of the rap group Migos. Migos' 2016 song, Bad and Bougie, was a huge hit, and what better way to celebrate with some chains that would make any 90s kid emerald green with jealousy? These Crash Bandicoot, Freakazoid, and Ratatouille-inspired chains were all made by Avion. But if none of these are nerdy enough, perhaps you might prefer his Yoda piece instead. Maybe the best-known modern-day jeweler is Ben Baller, born Ben Yang. He has more in common with the hip-hop community than most other jewelers. Before moving into the bling business, he worked as a producer for Dr. Dre. He made some truly beautiful, colorful pieces for Tyler, the Creator. He really has a knack for taking Tyler's fantasy sketches and turning them into reality. And one of my absolute favorite Ben Baller chains, just in terms of sheer weirdness, is this 55 karat black and white diamond Marilyn Manson pendant made for Lil Uzi Vert.
I saw the Dope Show, mm-hmm. and on that video, he has like platinum grills.
Yeah.
And I did not want them yellow golds no more.
He's
I
wanted that platinum.
And I got them just like them. They were plain platinum, six top, six bottom.
It's hard not to admire chains that are truly out there. I love Gucci Mane's Bart Simpson chain, but not as much as I like little Yachty's. Rick Ross's Rick Ross pendant is great, but I guess he can never really change his look. Lil Jon's Crunk Ain't Dead chain was honored by the Guinness Book of World Records in 2007 as the largest diamond pendant in the world. Kanye West's Jesus chain is based on the art of Takashi Murakami, and these fidget spinner daisy chains by Ben Baller are also based on Murakami's work. Now, that fidget spinner was made for reggaeton singer J Balvin rather than a rapper, but it was way too cool not to include. Are you feeling bad and bougie? Do you have any jewelry that boosts your hip-hop cred? Let us know in the comments section, and don't forget to like and subscribe. If you want to learn more about the information we discussed today, check out the links below. Thanks for watching.